Today, we create step-by-step an assembly of this Japanese toolbox. We have a shorter overview video of this toolbox, but in this video we will use FreeCAD version 0.19 and slowly go step-by-step through the assembly process. The first step is to create this spreadsheet with all the dimensions. For the box, these are the material thickness, as well as the inner width, height and length. We use a macro to create aliases for the numbers so that we can refer to them by name later. We covered the creation of spreadsheets and how to install this macro in the last tutorial. We saved the file with the spreadsheet under the file name master. Next, we create a new file for each individual board. In the part workbench, we add a cube. This cube gets the dimensions from the spreadsheet in the format filename, hashtag, table name, dot variable name. This would be, for example, master hashtag p dot material. The formulas are entered as we did in part 2 of this series. We start with the bottom piece. It does not matter which dimension is the thickness, so we can also use the height field of the cube for the material thickness. The length of the bottom is the inner width plus 2 times the material thickness for the side pieces. The width is the inner length plus 4 times the material thickness. Each cube gets saved in a separate file. The first one we name bottom. Next are the long sides. The width is the thickness of the material, the length is the same as the length of the bottom, and the height is the inner height plus the material thickness. After saving this cube to a file named long side, we get to the short sides. The length of these sides is the inner width, the width is the material thickness, and the height is the same as for the long sides. We can just modify the length field of the long side cube and save it with another name. We save the file as short side and then modify the height field to be a fourth of the inner height. This cube is saved as our handle. For the top pieces that will hold the lid in place, we add 2 times the material thickness to the length field of the handle and make the height 4 times the material thickness. Thank you. After saving this cube as lid side, the components of the box are done and we only need two more cubes for the lid. The lid handle is easy as it is nearly identical to the lid sides. We just modify the height field to be 2 times the material thickness. The last piece is the lid itself. The width is the inner width, the height corresponds to the material thickness, and the length is the inner length minus 2.1 times the material thickness. After creating all the files, following the same schema, we make sure the Assembly 2 Plus workbench is installed. Go to Tools, Add-on Manager, and install the latest version. Also make sure that in Edit Preferences A2 Plus, the checkbox for recalculate imported parts before updating them and use experimental topology naming are enabled. After switching to the A2 Plus workbench, we can now import the individual parts one by one with the button that shows a plus sign. These parts can then be aligned with one another in a variety of ways. For woodworking projects, most of the assemblies can be solved by making planes coincident. Just select 2 faces that you want to align while holding down the control key, click on the plane coincident button, and decide if the 2 objects are opposed or aligned with one another. After aligning 3 faces, the board is locked in place. If we need a copy of one of the parts, we can duplicate it with a button that looks like a staircase. Assembling a project this way is fast and actually quite fun. It is worth noting that there are several other assembly workbenches in FreeCAD. In particular, the new Assembly 4 workbench is worth to take a look. We will stick to the Assembly 2 Plus workbench for this tutorial series, as we will look into using it to create cut lists in the next part of the series. when putting the last lid handle in place, we don't want it to sit directly against the side piece. Just add an offset to the plane constraint and we are good to go. The great thing about this model is that it is fully parametric. We can, for example, decrease all the values to scale the box down to a size of a few centimeters. After cutting all the small shapes on the laser cutter, we can assemble a miniature box for small parts. If the video was helpful, please give it a like and don't forget to subscribe for more FreeCAD and project videos.